You've entered the wrap on KMBC.TV. Now, join the conversation with your comments, opinions, and questions.
Hello, everybody. I'm Laura Moritz. I got Larry Moore, Brian Busby, Kelly Eckerman up here. Larry has something he wants to say.
If you were watching our 6 o'clock news, you know that I was announcing that at the end of next month, I'll step away from the daily broadcast, but I'll still be part of KMBC 9 News and the projects and the Dream Factory and all the other things that we do here, and especially part of our news coverage every day. But as far as being on every night, that will end the eve of Thanksgiving.
The eve of Thanksgiving.
Okay.
So,
but you won't be done with us. You know.
No.
We're not letting him go.
I'll probably bother you more.
That's right. But, I'll be right here for all the things that are going on. But it'll just be nice to sort of step away from the daily grind. And, I have 5 grandkids, and Emmett is the oldest. And he says, we need to spend some time together, Grandpa.
Did he call the family meeting together?
No. Okay. No, he didn't call a family meeting. He's just kind of recognized as the leader.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
He's at home right now going, yes.
Yeah. He's the spokesman for the Moore family.
Spokesman, right. That's good. Yeah, the spokesman. So, it'll be fun. But I won't be leaving all of you. All of you. I'll be
we won't let you.
Well, I was going to say, and I don't think anybody in Kansas City will let you.
No, not at all.
It ain't going to happen.
Too involved in too many lives and too many hearts.
There's so many comments coming in. Karen says, I'll miss you so much. Have grown up with you, but understand the need to have special moments with the grandkids, as I have 5 of my own, and wish for more time with them.
There you go.
That's why I have 5. They keep you busy, too.
They do. Brenda says, I will miss Larry. And Brenda says, Larry needs to teach you how to tell the stories now, Len.
Oh, there you go.
And teach him the laugh, right?
The laugh, right?
Oh, I was sharing a story with the people here at the chat about earlier today about Larry's laugh. And I think we'll miss that, every single day hearing Larry's laugh. I told a quick story about how our news director came back from Branson with that big obnoxious pink hat that lit up.
Right.
And we were in the meeting in the other room, and then you heard Larry's laugh in the outside of the newsroom, and we all kind of looked at each other as like, he must have just saw Sherry's hat.
Yeah, Sherry wants to have some words with you a little later on, Len.
Yeah.
What people don't realize is that Larry Moore's laugh is so loud that my pen pal in Oslo, Norway, comments about it, because it can just waft.
That's very true.
Always know yes.
Wow. And Larry, what's Kelly had touched upon this. Well,
there we go.
Larry. Oh, that's awesome.
Earmuffs.
Nice.
Remember?
Oh, that was the first picture. That was at the Capitol, the coldest inaugurations in history.
What year would that be?
That would be about 84.
84. Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's show the next one. Yeah.
The round burgundy look.
Yeah, the round burgundy look. That's about.
Larry, your hair was 70, black.
Yeah, about 77. Hair was black. Hadn't fallen out yet.
Look at that. That was 40 years ago.
Len and I, 40 years ago. Yes.
Wow.
Yes. Yep. And,
yes.
That's part of the, actually, that's where we launched the Dream Factory with promo.
Mm-hmm. Remember that.
Mm-hmm. Long years ago. So, lots of memories, Of course, there's
let's keep this one up for a while.
Oh, that's right.
What's it like to do the Twas a Night Before Christmas year after year, knowing that you have all these moving parts?
Kelly's kids and my kids have been through it.
Exactly. The key is you just have to keep going. You can't stop. I mean, like one year, Kelly's daughter got up and just turned her back to the camera, stooped over, and left. And a minute later, she came back. And we just continued.
Well, she knew that part.
There was no stopping and no second takes, no cutting out the shot. We just went on.
Right. Yeah.
So that's what you have to do in that situation.
Okay. Yeah. And one of my favorite stories of my kids growing up in the newsroom, they used to all, Larry was a sure bet for candy. So all they'd have to do is say, Mr. Moore, how are you? Let's go to the candy machine.
That's right, exactly. They probably have bad teeth there.
Nothing a dentist can't fix.
Aubrey always called you Larry the Cucumber, because that was one of her favorite cartoon characters.
That's right.
Yep. He was always Larry the Cucumber.
Oh,
So, we all, like you said, our kids grew up with you, too.
Absolutely they did.
This time of year, this one's appropriate from Beth Klein. Congrats, Larry. Enjoy time with all the grandkids, but don't forget our ghost story.
I knew that was coming.
We had it on Sunday night on the news. That was a scary one. John B. Warnell House.
Yeah, that was a scary one.
That goes back to the Civil War, and there's some scary stories that come out of there.
Now, I had a pole on Jennings from out underneath the setting. Yeah. So scared.
Now, while shooting one, have you ever had an encounter?
Well, I tell you, you know, everybody asked me that, and there was probably one time.
Okay.
One time, and that was up at Atchison, the old cemetery at Atchison, where we were tracking down this ghost. And it's a very odd, ghostly story, but it's very scary to start with. But that particular night, snow was coming down. Fog was in the air.
Mm-hmm.
And right in the middle of shooting, the cemetery gates go closed and lock.
And they're not automatic or anything?
No. We had the producer who was with me had to leap over a wire fence to go get the gatekeeper to get the gates open so we could get out.
That was probably one of the scarier times.
Yeah. It didn't stop you.
Yeah, no, we got the story done. Yeah, it's one of the favorites happened over the years. But yes, you remember things like that.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, what would cause those gates just to close? You know, they weren't automatic gates or anything. They were just gates. And it wasn't windy. And all of a sudden they went closed. So, yeah, that was a scary one.
Yeah, That is. We've got some more pictures.
I
want people to see these. That's awesome. Now, those are some Dream Factory kids, aren't they?
Some of the Dream Factory kids, yes. Over 5,600.
Kelly! Look at Kelly!
Hey!
That's not me.
Oh, okay.
Looks like you.
Yeah.
Okay.
Great. I love that.
And
there's with Sarah.
Sarah Smith, who's our president and general manager. And
giving you your 40-year...
That was my 40-year certificate in the newsroom a while back. Yes.
Right.
And let's see. That's where we're doing a story on Missouri football. See, the one thing I established long years ago was that I was objective on every story except when it affects Mizzou football.
Right.
And then I can be subjective and editorial and all that sort of thing.
Yeah,
so I get a pass.
One pass.
Yeah, I get
not
a pass
bad.
On that. Right.
Yeah. Not bad in all those years. Yeah, not bad at all. Well, good. Sheila says, understandable, but so sorry to see you go. May God bless you always, Larry Moore.
Oh, very nice. Thank you, Sheila.
But you're not going anywhere, right?
No, we're
going
to be right here.
That's
It's just that I won't be on every night with you. That will
be
the difference.
And Emmett's going to have a lot bigger say in the day-to-day schedule,
He will have much more to say about the day-to-day.
Sounds like there's a lot of fishing in your future.
Fishing, oh yeah.
And
baseball.
Baseball and soccer.
He was getting signed up for his Blue Crew today for the Royals next year.
Is he still in the trains?
Pretty much, but you know, life moves on. Trains are not as big now as Legos are.
Ah.
Legos, big deal.
Larry, you have that Northeast Kansas City accent that my dad had. I lost him 28 years ago, but every so often I hear him in your voice. It has been a comfort. Thank you.
That really is.
Mm-hmm. Well, and that's what people can do. And so we're inviting everybody to go to our KMBC fan book page because you can leave a comment for Larry, which means so much. And it just kind of lets everybody share favorite stories about Larry.
I know. We'd have favorite stories. We could almost put together a book or something, couldn't we?
And you know, you can also offer advice to Ruth, his wife.
Exactly.
You might be able to pass along some anecdotes to Ruth as well. We'll open it up to that.
She'll need it. She will need it.
Ruth
may be spending more time at the station is what might happen.
Never thought of it that way.
Ruth, how are you?
Where's Larry? He's at home.
He's at home. What's the lead story tonight?
That's right.
Oh, yes. It's really great fun. There's no question about it. And even at my age, you just don't want to step away from it, you know,
and go
cold turkey because it'd be very, very difficult to do. So what we've arranged is a very neat transition project, and I'll be around for a couple of years doing all kinds of different things, including the Dream Factory, of course.
Good. Well, I think that'll probably do it for us here on The Wrap tonight, KMBC.tv. You can always join the conversation and join us at 9 on KCWE and at 10 on KMBC.
And we'll see you next time.